Hello, and welcome to another edition of the Daily Bolt with your host, Dr. Jeff Tilley. Today's topic: too much coffee isn't just bad for your sleep and maybe some other things, but perhaps for your brain as well. Sit back and relax and maybe get a cup of tea and enjoy today's Daily Bolt. So, this is actually the second Daily Bolt of the day, separate episode, separate topic. This is kind of a science topic of the day type of Daily Bolt. And it's going to be a fairly short and sweet episode, being the second one of the day. It involves a new study that was headed up by a group at the University of South Australia. There's international participation. It looked at a not terribly small, but not super large sample of people with respect to their habits in terms of drinking coffee and what that did in terms of, or at least how it was reflected in the brains of those individuals. In particular, they looked at effects of age. They looked at the effects of the brains themselves as scanned by various types of imagery, volumetric brain imaging data, and a wide range of other factors that are represented in the sample of 17,000 people. And while we don't really have a good solid chemical connection as to why this is the case, it was found that amongst the participants, especially those the age of 37 or greater, those who drank more coffee, and more coffee in this case, maybe 6, 7, 8 cups of coffee a day, that's a lot of coffee, though I know that I've drunk that much myself from time to time, had smaller brains. The actual volume of their brains was smaller, and they had a 53% increased risk of developing dementia. Dementia is a serious health condition. It's related to Alzheimer's disease in terms of some of the symptoms being similar, but it is considered a different condition. And whether or not they really examined Alzheimer's is not something that's revealed in terms of what I found so far in this study. But they did certainly look at the risk for dementia. They looked at the risk for stroke. And aspect of it where their brains were actually smaller than those who did not drink as much coffee or no coffee at all is kind of interesting. It suggests that somehow it shrinks your brain. And again, the exact chemical mechanism is not something that we know. But it does seem to be an interesting relationship. Hopefully this will spur some additional study. I don't know how exactly you would look at all of the brain chemicals that coffee might affect, but I suppose it would be possible with various types of tests, but those tests are probably very expensive and it might not be something that would be necessarily fundable. So the results, while interesting in this study, are kind of circumstantial. They suggest a correlation. They don't suggest the mechanism for the causation, because they were able to rule out virtually all the other confounding factors, whether they were overweight, whether they had other underlying medical conditions, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So it might suggest causation, but how is the key? Is it the caffeine? Is it something else in the coffee that comes out when you roast coffee beans and when you brew them? It's really hard to know. What they do recommend is something which makes a lot of sense anyway: moderation, the key to everything. Just like there are many things that are good for you until you eat 5,000 of them. Avocados are good for you until you eat 5,000 of them in one big streak and you don't eat anything else and you end up with lots of other deficiency diseases. So moderation, once again, comes out as the key. I have cut back on my own coffee consumption, not because of this study, but for other reasons, and I'm still cutting it back as we speak, And certainly, I'm drinking more tea, not just caffeinated tea, but a lot more herbal tea. And the other recommendation that the study authors have is if you're going to drink coffee, maybe drink some water along with it. And I know there's a lot of people who do that anyway. But gives you not food for thought, but drink for thought. That's it for today's Daily Bolt. Short episode. We'll be back with something else tomorrow. I hope you have a good night, good morning, good afternoon, whenever you listen to this. And have a great night's sleep. Don't drink too much coffee.